Andy was just, you know, this typical loud, noisy boy. Andy grew up being very outdoorsy and liked doing things like learning to shoot a flintlock and do hawk and knife throwing. And he was just kind of a rough and tumble boy. When Andy was diagnosed with the cancer, we were just busy with that all the time. The diagnosis was that he had cancer in his hip bone, so he had his whole left leg removed. And we had to adjust to that, but what do you do when you've got a kid that's active, wants to be active? Before Camp River Run, you know, we just kind of did our normal activities as best we could.
Andrew Knapp, I feel pretty humbled to even get to tell you about this young gentleman. He got bone cancer and he volunteered to be a counselor. He was too old to be a camper. He is the type of kid that he would probably volunteer to be a counselor anyway.
Of course he wanted to do that. He thought, camp? Why not? I like to camp.
His first year at camp, he is so darn cute because he just had such a wit about him.
He was always good with the younger kids and, you know, he was just an encouraging kid. They wanted to be like him.
He would throw his pant leg, you know, he'd always tuck his other pant leg where he didn't have his leg inside of his other pant. And he would throw in just the leg, the pant leg, and slam the trunk of the car. And he would sit there by the car and say, oh, ow, 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 you know, just to make people giggle.
He liked collecting knives. He collected two things. He collected nutcrackers and he collected knives.
He wanted to give back. He hands me this knife with a homemade duct tape sheathing that he made on it. And I said, Andrew, why are you giving me this knife? And he said, it's for Camp River Run Share in the Dream event.
I think he felt like this was something that he could donate and maybe another kid would benefit from it.
The Share in the Dream event at the time was in September. But he was giving it to me then. And I turned to him and I said, but Andrew, why are you giving me this now? And he looked right back at me and answered as truthful can be. And he said, because I won't be there, Shauna. And I sat there and I got kind of choked up like I'm doing right now. And I said, but Andrew, you will be there. He said, I will take this knife. I will see you there. And sure enough, Andrew wasn't there. He passed away that April.
It was just something that meant a lot to him that he felt like could be a good donation for the camp to run off on, and they did.
That knife, we auction off. We tell the story every year. We auction off that knife in Andrew's memory.
Somebody would bid on it and ran the bid pretty good. And then they turn it right back in and let somebody else bid on it.
So that first year, I can't even tell you, it's brought over hundreds of thousands of dollars to Camp River Run.
Sometimes a person would take the knife and keep it for a little while and do additions to it. Like one person put a shadow box in it, somebody made a new sheath for it, but they've kept Andrew's in that shadow box because that was the original one that he made. I didn't know after 11 years that it was still going on.
His goal is for Camp River Run to hit 100 years. So we're gonna do everything we can to make that possible.
You know, when you make a donation, it's usually a one-time thing. And to know that this keeps on giving is probably more than he would have ever dreamed of. It's more than I ever pictured.
He made his life a true example of how he wanted to live.
He was a giver. He loved making other people happy. And if he knew how many kids could benefit from the money that was raised just from his knife, he'd be excited.